So you're out of detention for the first time in a year and a half. You've been here at this apartment since Friday night. How's it feel to be semi-free?
Well, I'm so happy to be given this opportunity. I feel like I'm getting a second chance to fix my mistakes. Yeah, and I'm so happy ICE agreed to release me, even if it's just house arrest.
House arrest, and you have this ankle monitor
I
here.
do.
Is that annoying?
No, I'm getting used to it. They tighten it up a little bit, so it's not dangling as it used
Are
to.
you allowed to leave the apartment at all?
No.
Not at all.
No. Well, I'm supposed to check in with my criminal parole and my ICE officers, but otherwise, no.
And do you have any idea how long you're going to be in house arrest?
No, not yet. We're like figuring it out now.
Figuring it out.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to think how you pass the time. I know you do art now. This is your work.
So this is a reproduction of one of my sketches, the Delvey Crimes.
And then you have this free time. I don't know if you've had any time to binge any TV shows.
Oh no,
There's
not
one
at
on Netflix called Inventing Anna. I'm not sure if you've seen it.
all. No, not
You
yet.
haven't seen it?
No. But I still like about half an hour of it.
Maybe it's what's helped if you stop thinking about me like everyone else. Like basic, you know?
Have you heard, like, do you think she got your accent? Because it became her depiction of your accent was so famous for a while. There was even a skit on Saturday Night Live about it.
Basic,
And
you
you know,
know?
people would do the,
Sometimes
you're so basic, the people would do the accent. Is that something you enjoyed or thought was weird or what?
I don't think I sound like it, but I think she got me from the time before because I used to, like 10 years ago, I used to travel so much when I was like in my mid-20s. But now I just spend so much time in the States and I've like only been speaking English, so I guess my accent is not as strong as it used to be.
So I wonder, you wanted to be famous and well connected. You came to New York with all sorts of plans, and you're now known as a notorious con artist and grifter and liar. And I'm wondering, do you have any regrets?
Absolutely, yes. I feel so sorry for a lot of the choices I've made, but I also feel like I've learned so much and like I grew as a person.
Have you apologized to anyone?
Yes, I did.
Who?
Well, I said like, I'm very sorry for all the decisions I've made.
Oh, in court, you mean you said it. But have
Yeah.
you reached out to anybody? Have you reached out to any of your friends or the hotels or the restaurants or anyone?
Well, I didn't steal any money from friends. The only friend that was involved in my criminal case, I got acquitted of that count.
Right.
And everybody else is a financial institution.
But when you say right now, you just said that, you know, what you did it to financial institutions. It doesn't sound like you really regret what you did. You sound like you're almost kind of like casting it as though it was a victimless crime. It wasn't a victimless crime, right? I mean, you took advantage of people.
I definitely did, yeah. And I was younger and I learned from my mistakes.
But did you?
I
Did
did,
you learn
yes.
from those mistakes? I mean, are you not going to do anything like this ever again?
Absolutely not.
So you served 20 months in pretrial detention at Rikers. Then you were convicted. You did another 20 months. Then you were released. And then instead of going back to Europe, you did 18 months here in the United States in immigration custody.
That's right.
But why not be free in Europe instead of in detention in the United States? Can you help me
Because
understand
I'm
that?
trying to fix the mistakes that I've done in the past, and I feel like if I were to leave and say, "Oh, whatever," I'm just going to move on and like move to Europe. I would be like accepting the labels that they're trying to slap on me. So I think like me just staying in jail and trying to prove people wrong, gotta stand for something. I hope people will recognize it.
But what do you mean prove people wrong? By staying in the United States and doing what? How are you going to prove anybody wrong?
Well, I'm still on my criminal parole. I'm still with ICE, and I'm trying to comply with all the rules and restrictions they're placing on me and just kind of change the narrative.
What's your case to immigration for why you should get to stay in the United States after everything that happened? Why should the American people let you stay here knowing how effectively you conned and fleeced so many Americans here already?
Well, I feel like I deserve a second chance. It was one mistake that I've made, and I've served my time, and I feel like I should deserve a second opportunity.
So you wrote a letter blasting the US immigration system. You wrote, quote, "Female detainees are tossed in with the general criminal population, where a Honduran mother frantic to contact her family is locked up with a convicted murderer who starved her 7-year-old to death." So you want to change the system in what way? To keep violent offenders and nonviolent offenders separated?
I feel like nonviolent immigration offenders should not be incarcerated.
at all.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like if you just get an ankle bracelet, that's that serves immigration purposes, because I feel like incarceration is very punishing, and somebody who like overstayed their visa is being put under the same conditions as somebody who committed like a violent crime.
Do you think there's something about the United States where we are fascinated by con artists, grifters, liars? Is there something that we like, that we find interesting?
I would say so, yes. I was thinking if I were to be prosecuted for similar crimes in Germany, I don't think people would really care.
Is that right?
Yeah. So I feel like I never really wanted to be famous.
You didn't want to be famous? No. You just wanted to be influential and well-connected.
Yeah, I just wanted to like work on my business. And I feel like part of it was the prosecution, the way they portrayed me, and just the media. They kind of created this idea of me, and I'm just being left to deal with it.
But you convinced people that you were an heiress, that you had lots of money that you didn't have, and
I actually never said that to anybody. That was just an assumption they had.
Well, see, you're saying all this stuff to me. It doesn't sound like you're really actually all that repentant. It doesn't sound like you're actually really regret what you did, or even necessarily think you did anything wrong.
I mean, I made a lot of wrong choices.
Like what?
While just misrepresenting, I guess, my financials to financial institutions. Mm-hmm. But I'm trying to like not glamorize my crimes and not lead anybody to believe that that's the way to get famous, because I suffered a lot as a result, like as a consequences of my actions too. Even though like I don't always show it, I'm not like going to go on TV and cry, but like I've done a lot of time in jail, and it's been very hard a lot of times.
So what's the plan now for how you're going to support yourself?
I am working on my podcast and on doing more of my art. I'm so very happy. I've been afforded a second chance to to stay here and to fix my mistakes. And hopefully I will be known for some of my legit projects and not just what I've been trying to do when I was in my early to mid-20s.
Okay. The best is yet to come, is what
you're
saying. Yes. Okay.